Jermall Charlo defeats Juan Montiel over the course of 12 rounds. I want to give some quick reactions. You guys seen the beginning. What up, Fight World? It's your boy Ego, and I'm back with some more boxing. You seen the beginning. I put the reactions of a lot of the boxing world and some of the celebrities and people who were watching Charlo Montiel. I want to give some brief initial reactions. Great fight. You know, this was a sleeper. I told you guys that based on the all access, based on my research and what I knew, that Montiel was going to do just what he did. Be game, show up. He has some dangerous power. I like what Charlo did over the course of 12 rounds. For the beginning of the fight, I thought Jermall Charlo was fundamentally super sound. Great execution and attack to the body. He jabbed. He was fainting. And all in all, he was offsetting Montiel. Now, credit to Montiel. I think Montiel came out with a different look, but it didn't befuddle Charlo. Earlier in the fight, Montiel came out with the real herky-jerky, awkward style. He was given like kind of like the Notre Dame mascot, giving different looks, trying to change levels, trying to confuse. I think he thought that he was going to try to trap and convince Jermall Charlo to foolishly and aggressively come forward. But Jermall Charlo stayed his course, and he wasn't taking and falling for the bait. And I thought he looked real, real good in the early rounds, just being patient, exercising that beautiful jab. Him and his brother have that Texas jab. Errol Spence has a great jab as well. And all in all, it was a good fight. Montiel, I think where kind of the ebb and flow changed a little bit, even though this was a one-sided and dominant performance by Jermall Charlo, I think the only thing that Jermall Charlo could do differently or tighten up on, I think as soon as he badly hurt Montiel in one of the mid rounds, he got a little overzealous and he tried to pile it on. And I think that's not a problem as long as you think you can hurt somebody. But once you've seen he wasn't there and ripe for the picking, then you go back to the regular, you know, putting the regular fruit in the basket and stuff, so to speak. Sometimes it's not always ripe. You eat the wrong fruit and it's not ripe, fully ripe. It's going to be bitter and you're going to spit it out and stuff like that. So boxing, you have to be very cautious. And I think for a minute, Montiel started to come on in spots, still losing the rounds, but still making it fun enough and dangerous enough for Charlo. Charlo, he looked like he was breathing kind of hard and got gassed because he was pummeling and punishing the dude, and the dude kept coming forward like the Terminator. So all in all, it turned out to be a very solid fight. Jermall Charlo, he looked good. You know, the haters going to say whatever they want to say, but he looked good. Ultimately, credit to Montiel for his chin, his heart, his determination and grit. I would definitely like to see him come back. We know Charlo will be back as a champion. The fight surprisingly went 12 rounds to a lot of people, but this is boxing. You're not going to be able to knock everybody out. And Montiel showed that he deserved and wanted the opportunity, and he fought his heart out. And even though he was losing the rounds, he was trying to make it interesting and doing little things here and there to make it interesting enough. So I really enjoyed this one. Great main event from Showtime. Charlo, when he kind of lost his way and didn't stick to some of the things that got him to the point of hurting Montiel, that's where he had kind of his rockiest moments, or just there was no moment, no one was knocked down or anything like that, but just that's where it became harder, because I think he should have just stuck to the game plan, the fundamentals and the basics, instead of the phone booth and giving Montiel, his corner even told him he needed a knockout to win, so don't give him any way back into the fight. And Montiel was landing some punches in spots. Charlo took him. Montiel took his best work. So it turned out to be explosive, and you know, had enough of a good competitive work. There was a credit to both fighters. They were very respectful of each other. And how could you not, after both guys, you know, no one comes to lay down, and both guys show up and they show that they wanted to be there. So all in all, it was a good fight. I think Charlo late in the fight got back to his jab, and he started getting, like, he was tired, so he started getting back to the basics and the jab. Those are the championship level adjustments I'd like to see. Instead of phone booth fighting and, you know, finding out this guy won't go and he just keeps coming, go back to your fundamentals, your skill set. You're the speedier fighter. You're the champion. You're the more athletic fighter. And then that's what he did. And he went, he won the fight. You know, easy. Easy to score, I guess you could say. But definitely a challenge just because he had a relentless guy with insane amount of pressure. Drop your thoughts in the comment section. Let me know how the fight was. What do you want to see next from both? As always, hate, comment, and subscribe. Till next video is Ego signing off. Are you tired of your YouTube videos not getting any views? Well, consider TubeBuddy. I've used TubeBuddy for years to scale up my YouTube channel. Now we're sitting over 200,000 subscribers. TubeBuddy is a browser extension that offers a ton of built-in productivity and time-saving services to take your channel to the next level. Use my link in the description to get started with TubeBuddy and level up your channel faster. We working.